Alright folks, what we have here is a Toyota Venza. Most of the Toyotas have this type of a brake system. If not, it has the handle that you pull up for the parking brake and emergency brake. Other cars have this too. This is the regular just push on, push off. So you use your foot and you push down on it. You're supposed to hear click, 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 and then it's supposed to lock into its place. Then to release it, you push it again and it comes off. But if you notice, this one is not. There's no more click, click. Okay, it usually goes click, 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 and the harder you push it, the further it locks down. But this one is not working. With the car off, you can hear a little squeaky sound. So I'm gonna say that the cable is working, but let's try it. What we're gonna do is we're gonna start the car, put it in drive or reverse, step on that and see if it stops the car. Okay, if it does, then you know that the cable is good all the way down to the back of the wheels, and it pulls the two emergency brake drums. Okay, it's inside the rotors. They look like little brake shoes, like in a drum setup. They're inside the rotor hat. Okay, there's a primary and a secondary. Looks like an old brake drum setup. So let's go start it up. All right, yeah, there's usually one cable. Goes down, then splits into two, left and a right. So let's go start this little guy up. We're gonna put it in drive and use that emergency brake or the parking brake. Everybody calls it differently. And we're gonna see if it stops the car. If it stops the car, listen, at least we know that's good. We just gotta find out what's wrong with it in the mechanism. You hear like one click. See it? Oh, see that, it held it. No. No more. Oh, there you go. Oh, it's getting better. Oh, there it goes. No more. I bet you it's dirt, because it hasn't been used in a while. You know, you only use it when you're on a hill, on an incline, and stuff like that. So it's probably got dirt on it. Probably have to spray clean it, but it looks like that panel has to come out, because it looks pretty tight in there. All right, let's put it in drive. Okay, I'm going to close the door so you don't have to hear that. So I'm going to step on the brakes, step on the emergency brake. It's in drive now. I've got to keep this open so I can show you that it's moving or not. Okay, so we know the brake system works. It's going to reverse. Ooh. See, that hasn't been used in a while, huh? It's all the rust. All right. So we know it works. We know the cable is good. Now we have to check to see why it's not locking. Looks like it bolts on there with a couple bolts to the side of the car. I'm gonna do that. Josh. Got my flashlight here somewhere. Let's see what this looks like underneath. Here's the mechanism. Here is the cable. There's a little dust bunnies under there. All right, there's the mechanism. This is attached to. There's a ratcheting system. So it's up in here, people. Okay, it's up in there. There's a little ratchet. There's some gears in there. Most likely it's all dust. Probably the grease that they use. It's usually a white grease that they use. Over years it gets cruddy. And it's probably preventing a gear from turning and locking in place. Alright, so I'm going to take these panels off and see if we take a better look. Alright, so to get to that panel here, we're going to pop this sill plate here. It's just plastic clips. Just be careful because it is old enough to break. All right, the little Christmas tree clips, three over here, and then it latches on to the sides of those covers. All right, put them off to the side. This one here has a little twist nut over there that I guess lost a long time ago or fell off. And then this just pops out too. There's a clip up here and a clip down here. You pull it up nice and easy and that will come out. All right, it's a push clip there. and a slotted clip that goes in there. And then that comes out. Push that off to the side. And then what we're looking at is this mechanism. Looks like it's got three nuts to it, 12 millimeter nuts. Okay, there is one. The other one's on the left side, and there's one all the way in the back up on top. So this is three. Three will remove this unit. I don't see anything plugged into it, so when I start to remove them, they are 12 millimeters. 12 millimeters. Okay, somebody's using 12 millimeters. Usually it's only 13 or 10s. All right, I'm going to start to remove that. All right, so here's the mechanism out. All right, the three bolts. This one over here, all the way on the top. A little hard to get to, but this one is even harder. The one that's more towards the dash. Because there's all kinds of wiring and stuff like that. You got to go on an angle. You might need a swivel. All right. But from what it looks like, it looks basically, well, the mechanical part of it is good. The gears are good and everything. There's a little spring that holds this little doodad right there. You see a little speck of white grease there. I'm assuming that that is not moving freely, so it's not grabbing that. Other than that, everything looks good, mechanical wise. There's a spring, there's a return spring. There is a switch over here, you just gotta unplug it, squeeze a little tab. Okay, there's more grease in there. This is the cable, it wraps around here and attaches there with a nut. Other than that, I don't see anything wrong with it. We're just gonna clean it up with some brake cleaner and we're gonna lube it up. Okay, that's what we're gonna do. I mean, if you don't want to take it apart, you can just shoot it with WD-40 or something, but I wouldn't recommend it only because you got all the electrical wiring in here. Okay, so you go shooting all that stuff, it's got to go somewhere, and you're going to end up with other problems. So take it out. I'm going to put it into a little basin over here somewhere so nothing gets all over the car. Then we're going to clean this little bugger up. All right. Alright, so after I sprayed the whole thing with brake cleaner, okay, I'm going to show you a little culprit right here. This thing here, right here, is the culprit. Okay, this is what, it's got a little spring on there, pulls it away from the gear. That is the problem right there. Alright, so now, after it's all clean, I want to lube it up. I'm not going to use WD-40, sorry, but WD-40 will stick with more dirt and grime would grab onto it. Grease is another thing, everything attaches to. So I'm going to use something with a Teflon. This is old school LPS. Otherwise, I think Liquid Wrench makes one with Teflon. Okay, so basically you want something with a little Teflon because it stays a lot better. I'm going to spray up the whole area here. And then when I get it to go, and it should work. Let's see if I can put you down here for a second here. Oh. Let's try it this way. Alright, let's try it this way. So I can work around the camera for you. I'm gonna show you that it's back to ratchet. Just put my gloves on, that's all I'm doing. Alright. Move a little prop out of the way. Here's some of my rigs. All over the mat right now. Okay, I'm gonna flip it this way. A little hard to grab it, but we get the basic idea. Let's see how we can do it. This way, maybe? And this way, left handed. Oops, don't want to knock the camera out. Okay, here you go. Back to normal. Click, click, push down, release. Click, click. All right, let me see if I can face it down a little bit more for you. How about that? All right, well, this is hard when you have to hold the freaking thing too. All right, there you go. Back to normal. All right, so I'm gonna spray a little bit over here, and then I'm gonna reassemble it, and you're gonna be good to go. Do that. So basically it's just the dirt holding that little lock gear probably holding it away, and that's why the one with all the teeth is just spinning around. So this has to stay down, so it goes click, 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 and it locks into each one of those gears as it turns. If it's away, then it's a free-for-all, right? So you want it down, so every time you step on it, you hit one click, goes to the next click, click, and then it stays in. And I guess when you step on it, it probably releases it, and that's how it comes back. All right, click, click. There you go. All right, I'm gonna loop this back on, put all my panels back on, and then we'll check it again. Here's the position of the three bolts. This is the one on the bottom, the one all the way up on top, it's above that ground. The one to the left is over here, underneath this harness over here. It's hard to see it. Right there, see it? That's the hardest one to get to. This one over here. Come on, can you move this out of the way? Believe me, stuff is hard to get to. Get out of the wiring harnesses and stuff. But that's the one. All right, that's the one. You can see how close it is to some modules over here. That's a tough one to get to. All right, one, two, and three. All right, everything is in, everything is bolted. Don't forget to put the plug in for the switch. Do it a little, one more test before we put the panels on, and we're pretty much done. All right, there you go. Great, right? It's good as new. So what it was basically old grease holding back that little gear that locks it. All right, like I said, I don't recommend shooting WD-40 or anything in there, only because it starts to drip and you're gonna mess up this whole electrical connections over here and you have other problems. Just bolt it off. I put it over here, I put it in like a little pail, and I shot the brake fluid over it, cleaned up, and I lubricated it at the same time. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching. Ciao.